This year, we're definitely rolling at Formnext. And this computer, printed by SEAD with T100GF eco-sustainable material, is already really cool. But get ready to see 5 of the coolest things we saw at Formnext 2024. The Jenny system showcased at Photocentric's booth here at Formnext is a modular system able to autonomously produce parts. It uses resin nodes to print parts and then washes them and cures them inside, meaning you have final parts ready for use at the end of the cycle. If you're doing dental arches, for example, which is a common use case, one module made up of 18 nodes, those being printers and post-processing stations, you'll be able to make up to 1.3 million dental arches a year, an astonishing number. Modular machines seem to be a real trend here at Formnext 2024, and Metrom is showcasing their CNC machines that can be fitted with a WAM head, an extrusion head, or a CNC milling tool to be able to manufacture custom parts. This one may be relatively small, but there exists the same version, just 10 times bigger, and it can move along a 15 meter long axis. This exact version can be fitted on a robotic arm to be able to eliminate the lack of precision of said robotic arm. Coming at us right from CFC's booth, which is a brand new company showcasing their printer, which is a continuous fiber affordable solution, selling right around $10,000 for the machine plus a drying station. In here, you can put up to 12 kilograms of material and then print with a modular printer, which can either print continuous fiber or dual material. Precise quality control is a huge step in achieving success with additive manufacturing. That's why GrindSonic, a spin-off from the University of Leuven, is qualifying parts by measuring the resonance frequency. To do so, the machine will hit the part with a given strength, always in the same spot, to measure the resonance frequency and then qualify Young's modulus, tensile strength and other parameters. And here we are at Carbon Cleaner, a company making recycled carbon fiber infused filament. But how does this work? Do they take end-of-life carbon fiber parts from automotive and aerospace applications and chop them down into chopped fibers to put into PETG or PA filaments? For example, KTM made this bike saddle by using recycled PP and carbon fiber from their motorcycles to make a new saddle with injection molded pellets. And that's about it for the roundup of the coolest things we saw at Formnext 2024. And knock on 3D printed cement, we'll see even more next year. See you soon!